Hi guys, in this video we are going to see the simple and easiest chapter, the coal and petroleum. Without any delay, let's get into our
chapter 5, coal and petroleum.
We use various materials of our basic needs. Some of them are found in nature and some have been made by human. Does this list include air, water, soil and minerals? Since all these are obtained from nature, they are called natural resources. Can air, water and soil be exhausted by human activities? You have already studied about water in class 7. Is water a limitless resource? In the light of the availability of various resources in nature, natural resources can be broadly classified into two kinds. Inexhaustible natural resources. These resources are present in unlimited quantity in nature and are not likely to be exhausted by human activities. Example are sunlight, air. Exhaustible natural resources. The amount of these resources in nature is limited. They can be exhausted by human activities. Examples of these resources are forest, wildlife, minerals, coal, petroleum, natural gas, etc. Assume that the eatables in the container represents the total availability of an exhaustible natural resources like coal, petroleum or natural gas. Now, each group may have different conception pattern. Are the earlier generation of any group too greedy? It may be that the earlier generation in some groups were concerned about the upcoming generations and left something for them. In this chapter, we will learn about some exhaustible natural resources like coal, petroleum and natural gas. These were formed from the dead remains of living organism fossils. So they are also known as fossil fuels. Coal. You may have seen coal or heard about it. It is as hard as stone and is black in color. Coal is one of the fuels used to cook food. Earlier, it was used in railway engines to produce steam to run the engine. It is also used in thermal power plants to produce electricity. Coal is also used as a fuel in various industries. About 300 million years ago, the earth had dense forest in low-lying wetland areas. Due to natural processes like flooding, these forests got buried under the soil. As more soil deposited over them, they were compressed. The temperature also rose as they sank deeper and deeper. Under high pressure and high temperature, dead plants got slowly converted to coal. As coal contains mainly carbon, the slow process of conversion of dead vegetation into coal is called carbonization. Since it was formed from the remains of the vegetation, coal is also called as fossil fuels. When heated in air, coal burns and produces mainly carbon dioxide. Coal is processed in industry to get some useful products such as coke, coal tar and coal gas. Coke. It is a tough, porous and black substance. It is almost pure form of carbon. Coke is used in the manufacture of steel and in extraction of many metals. Coal tar. It is black, thick liquid with an unpleasant smell. It is a mixture of about 200 substances. Products obtained from coal tar are used as starting material for manufacturing various substances used in everyday life and in industry, so like synthetic dyes, drugs, explosives, perfumes, plastic, paints, photographic materials, roofing materials, etc. Interestingly, naphthalene balls used to repel moths and other insects are also obtained from coal tar. These days, bitumen and petroleum product is used in place of coal tar for metalling the roads. Coal gas. Coal gas is obtained during the processing of coal to get coke. It is used as fuel in many industries situated near the coal processing plants. Friends, please highlight these two points also. Coal gas was used for street lighting for the first time in London in 1810 and in New York around 1820. Nowadays, it is used as a source of heat rather than light. Petroleum. You know that petrol is used as a fuel in light automobiles such as motorcycles, scooters and cars. Heavy motor vehicles like trucks and tractors run on diesel. Natural resource called petroleum. Petrol and diesel are obtained from a natural resource called petroleum. The word petroleum is derived from petra, rock, and oleum, oil, as it is mined from between the rocks under earth. Do you know how petroleum is formed? Petroleum was formed from organisms living in the sea. As these organisms died, their bodies settled at the bottom of the sea and got covered with layers of sand and clay. Over millions of years, absence of air, high temperature and high pressure transformed the dead organism into petroleum and natural gas. Look, it shows the deposits of petroleum and natural gas. You see the layer containing petroleum, oil and gas is above that of water. Why is it so? Recall that oil and gas are lighter than water and do not mix with it. The world's first oil well was drilled in Pennsylvania, USA in 1859. 8 years later, in 1869, oil was struck at Makum in Assam. In India, oil is found in Assam, Gujarat, Mumbai, and in the river basins of Godavari and Krishna. Refining of petroleum. Petroleum is a dark, oily liquid. It has an unpleasant odor. It is a mixture of various constituents such as petroleum gas, petrol, diesel, lubricant, or lubricating oil, paraffin wax, etc. The process of separating the various constituents fractions of petroleum is known as refining. It is carried out in petroleum refinery. Various constituents of petroleum and their uses are given below. This is the table. Let us give a short readout. Constituents of petroleum and uses. Petroleum gas in liquid form, LPG, fuel for home and industry, petrol, motor fuel, aviation fuel, solvent for dry cleaning, kerosene, fuel for stoves, lamps and for jet aircraft, diesel, fuel for heavy motor vehicles, electric generators, lubricating oil, lubrication, paraffin wax, ointments, candles, vaseline, etc., bitumen, paints, road surfacing. Many useful substances are obtained from petroleum and natural gas. These are termed as petrochemicals. These are used in the manufacture of detergents, fibers, polyester, nylon, acrylic, etc., polythene and other man-made plastics. Hydrogen gas obtained from natural gas is used in the production of fertilizers, urea. Due to its great commercial importance, petroleum is also called as black gold. Natural gas. Natural gas is very important fossil fuel because it is easy to transport through pipes. Natural gas is stored under high pressure as compressed natural gas. CNG. CNG is used for power generation. It is now being used as a fuel for transport vehicles because it is less polluting. It is a clear fuel. The great advantage of CNG is that it can be used directly for burning in homes and factories where it can be supplied through pipes. Such a network of pipelines exists in Vadodara, Gujarat, some parts of Delhi and other places. Natural gas is also used as a starting material for the manufacture of number of chemicals and fertilizers. India was
India has vast resources of natural gas. In our country, natural gas has been found in Tripura, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and in the Krishna Godavari Delta. Some natural resources are limited. You have studied in the beginning of the chapter that some natural resources are exhaustible like fossil fuels, forest minerals, etc. You know that coal and petroleum are fossil fuels. It required the dead organism millions of years to get converted into these fuels. On the other hand, the known reserves of these will last only a few hundred years. Moreover, burning of those fuels is a major cause of air pollution. Their use is also linked to global warming. It is therefore necessary that we use these fuels only when absolutely necessary. It will result in better environment, smaller risk of global warming and their availability for a long period of time. India, the Petroleum Conservation Research Association, PCRA, advises people how to save petrol or diesel while driving. Their trips are drive at constant speed and moderate speed as far as possible. Switch off the engine at traffic lights or at a place where you have to wait. Ensure correct tire pressure. Ensure regular maintenance of the vehicle. Let us read out the keywords. Coal, coal gas, coal tar, coke, fossil fuels, natural gas, petroleum, petroleum refinery. Let us give a recap by reading what you have learnt. Coal, petroleum and natural gas are fossil fuels. Fossil fuels were formed from the dead remains of living organisms millions of years ago. Fossil fuels are exhaustible resources. Coal tar, coke, coal tar and natural coal gas are the products of coal. Petroleum gas, petrol, diesel, kerosene, paraffin wax, lubricating oil are obtained by refining petroleum. Coal and petroleum resources are limited. We should use them judiciously. Guys, I think this video will be helpful for you. Please subscribe our channel, like and share. If you want any other lessons, please type it in our comment box with your standard and the chapter name.